music of a banga.
In a word of prayer.
Before we pray, I want to make sure that we understand that prayer is not a recitation. It's a conversation. So I'm going to ask you to bow your heads with me and let's have a conversation with God. Almighty God, we thank thee that thy grace is greater than our sin and greater than we are. And thy grace, O God, can bring salvation to all who believe. Touch our lives in a new way. Help our children, O God, to set goals and move in those directions. Bless the parents that we might be more supportive. And give us, O God, when all is done and said, the wisdom to know the difference. So bless us in this evening's function, that all which takes place may bring glory to thee and help us move forward just one step. This is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
I want to introduce Mr. Hollis Clifton to do a welcome first before I take the mic and proceed. Please be seated. Sorry, brother. Please be seated. Yeah, Mr. Stiles.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Okay, accidents do happen. We just heard one. Okay. I first of all would like to apologize for the late start, but these things happen. It's the real world. So welcome to the real world. This organization, the Carlton Lane Community Group, has been in existence for quite some time. The program that we are about to offer, the SCA Awards ceremony, was the initiative of the gentleman who did the invocation. Can we give a round of applause to Pastor Dr. Loney? Would you take a stand, sir? Okay. Right. Whatever happened, the group fell apart. And it was up to the Carlton Lane Community Group to pick up the pieces. So we are here today, and we are going to honor 17 young people from around this area, the Coffee Street Cipero area, in particular the HDC apartments, east, west, north, and south of Cipero Street. Okay? I want to hand you over to the man who has the mantle to pull back the Carlton Lane Community Group together. You may recall some time ago, the buildings in Carlton Lane were demolished by the HDC. We lost those residents. They have been displaced. In fact, they have been placed in Current Hills, all of them. Well, but we still have HDC buildings in off Carlton Lane. We have the Lowen Street apartments, and we have the Maiden Street apartments. So, Dwayne Jim Brown is the man of the moment. He has been after me to get something going in Carlton Lane. And Carlton Lane has had a reputation, right? I think you all know. I was living quite in a place called Botswana, and I was reading about drive-by shootings. But we went way back before most of you here were born, right? We had all kind of things like Woodstock and basketball. We had a septic tank, which has now been replaced with a basketball court. And we used to take part in competitions in Skinner Park, in Monipo. We used to invite people from all over Trinidad to come and have exchange encounters with us in Carlton Lane. And this is the young man who is taking the pledge to handle stories from now on. So we expect you to cooperate with him. So can we give Jim Brown a round of applause, please, as he takes over?
Thank you, Mr. Hollis. Thanks, man. Good night to each and everyone. Good night. First of all, I want to give thanks to Mr. Dr. Loney for starting the fire. And I look into starting to reignite it. Nice, man. All right. Secondly, I want the 17 children that we have here tonight, I want to stand, please. Because we're here to honor you all. You all stand up. Yeah. Yeah, stand up, please. Stand up. I just want to give you all a little something to think about, right? You all are young, and you all are vulnerable to the peer pressures, the pressures of life. You all are vulnerable to ill-thinking things. And I want you all to know that all the parents here tonight fight for you all. You know, fight to give you all what you all need. And probably they don't have all, right? They wouldn't have all. So I want to still honor all the parents like we honor you all today. So I want to give all the parents that is here, turn around and give all a hug. First of all, because they have to respect all the mother and all the father, you understand? I want to give all the parents a hug. Nobody doing it? Go give all the parents a hug. Give all your parents a hug. Tell all your parents how you love them. First things first, we're dealing with that. We need love in the community amongst the youths. And first, it have to start at home. Right? It have to start at home. Night, all I can sit down. Well, tonight, here to help honor you all, we have, and greetings, we have Ms. Sherry Ali, first of all. We have Ms. the Honorable Counselor. We have, from the San Fernando business community, we have Ms. Mercedes Belgroves, daughter of Mr. Keith Belgroves. Nice. Entertainment, we have Impulse for you all tonight. He's on his way. Next, feature speaker. Unfortunately, he wouldn't be here tonight because he on his walkabout in Larmin at present. Well, I now left him in Larmin, I should say. And he apologized that he could not make it tonight. But fortunately, you always see plenty of him. Trust me, I'm not telling you that. Yes, we get into that. Right, we have Mr. Rigolo presently. Mr. Rigolo, I want to thank you for the plenty of many things that you have done and to assist me, to assist my community, and to assist these kids here. Right? We have the vote of thanks coming from the Ministry of Gender and Youth Affairs and Child Development. We have it from Ms. Wendy Samuel. Right? Here to give you all greetings tonight is Ms. McQuan from the San Fernando Gills Anglican School.
Thank you, Ms. McQuan. Good night. Thank you very much, Mr. Brown. Deputy Mayor, Mr. Regrello, members of the head table, Pastor Tony, Mr. Fahey from First Citizen, Gulf City Ranch, Ms. Belgrove from within the business community, and Ms. Samuel from the Ministry of Gender Youth Affairs. It is indeed a pleasure for me to be invited here this evening. I heard 6 o'clock. I made it my business to be here at 6 o'clock. It's now way past 7. And I just want to say that I am at present a retiree. Today it makes it 1 month since I have retired after teaching within the community for 41 years at Coffee Boys Anglican School and serving as principal at San Fernando Girls Anglican School. I live within the community. I live a stone's throw from here on Carib Street. And thank you, Mr. Clifton, for inviting me and affording me this opportunity. To the awardees, I want to let you know that you have been chosen here this evening, and you have an obligation to all of us. You are here not only to receive gifts and tokens and monetary rewards, you are here to accept it and know that you have to move forward. And in moving forward, you have a responsibility to your community. Kudos must go to Carlton Lane community group that have identified all of you, and you have been selected, you have been chosen. And I know I'm bringing greetings here on behalf of all the principals and teachers within the Victoria region, especially in this area. And we know that when you go after those secondary schools, we normally track your progress. We are not telling you to go and work miracles at the secondary school. We are telling you to go there and do your best. We would not like to know that when you go to the secondary school, bad things happen. So we want to advise you, coming from all the other principals and the teachers, follow your hearts. We want to let you know, choose the right friends. You must know. And there's a saying that goes, do the right thing and do the right thing always. So that when Mr. Clifton and members and representatives of the Carlton Lane group, they visit the schools or they call the schools, they would only be hearing positive things happening to all of you. So I want to wish all of you the very best. Enjoy this afternoon and just tell yourself that the support is great within the community, and we just want you to go to the secondary schools, achieve, 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 and may God be with you and bless all of you for greater success in your future endeavors. Thank you very much.
Well, when I came on just now, I forgot an important body of people that I want to shout out to, which is my committee, my committee at the back here. I don't know what they're doing in the back hall here. They're supposed to be in the front. But all that night, and this is my committee for the back. Nice. Next, we want to bring on Miss Mercedes Belgroves to give greetings to our awardees. So we'll have Miss Mercedes.
All right, good night, everyone. Good night to the planning committee and so on. Thanks for having me. And I want to say a special good night to the guests of honors, the boys and girls here who were successful in their C exam, and you're going on to Form 1 over on the 8th. I have a question. So now I'm talking to you guys. So I need answers, right? This is like class. Are you proud to be from San Fernando? Anybody? Show of hands. Anybody? Some people, not everybody. Are you proud to be from Trinidad and Tobago? Yeah? So I've seen some people shaking their heads, some people might be a little bit afraid. But let me tell you, we are all proud of you, and we are proud that you are from San Fernando. Did you know that the business community here, I am here to bring greetings to you from the business community. My name is Mercedes Belgrove, and my family has run Belgrove's Funeral Home just across the street for 127 years. And I was born on Coffee Street. I born and grew up here. And so did you know that the members of the business community, all these businesses you see on Coffee Street, on Sapiro Street, on Sutton Street, did they know that they are interested in you? Did you know that? No? I seen some people saying, no, you didn't know. But let me tell you, businesses in San Fernando are interested in you because, let me tell you, you already passed one milestone. You were successful in your SEA exam, you were successful, and now you're going on to secondary school. And in 5 short years, don't think it's a lot of years, 5 short years, you're going to do CXC, and you're going to be successful then as well. And then you're going to go on and you're going to do A-levels, and you're going to be successful at A-levels. And then guess what is the next step? University. Because each and every one of you belong in university. You are going to UWE, you're going to go to UTT, you're going to go to some, maybe some of you may be fortunate enough to get a scholarship to go abroad or so, but you're going to university. And when you are successful in university in just maybe 20 or so years, and don't think 20 sounds like a big number, but when you are successful in university, you are setting the foundation now to be successful in university. You are going to come back to our proud city of San Fernando, and you are going to work in our businesses, and that's why business people are interested in you. You are going to be the managers in our businesses, and that is why business people are interested in you. And you are going to come here and you are going to open business. You are going to open a business next to my business, and you are going to be the business people in San Fernando, and we are interested in you. And if you're not opening a business, then you're going to be a doctor, a lawyer, a police officer. You're going to be in Trinidad and Tobago Regiment. You're going to be a fire officer, a chef. You're going to do something for our city here in San Fernando. Is that anybody's goal? Does anybody want to be a doctor, a lawyer, anything like that? Something like that? Yes, some people. Excellent. Because you have goals. I have a few items here that I just want to share with you quickly.
We could share these out. They're not doing it now.
So I have a small exercise. We're not going to do it now. This is homework. Oh, y'all thought you were on vacation. You're not getting homework. Yes, this is homework. So I'm giving you this item here. And I would just talk briefly on it. But I want you to really, maybe tomorrow after you wake up and you have your cereal for breakfast and so on, I want you to take a look at this and really take it seriously. This item here, the first page, talks about a roadmap for success. And this here, boys and girls, let me tell you, this is a secret. This is a secret to success in life. So I'm giving you a secret here. So listen up. The road to to success, the first step is dream big. So I see some doctors and future lawyers and some future business people and so on here in the audience. Dream big. When you go to bed tonight, see yourself in the role you want to play. If you want to be a doctor, see yourself in your lab coat. In 20 years, I will be coming with my walking stick and you will be my doctor. Dream big. Keep your dreams inside of your head all the times. Second step, write your goals down. The second page of this package that I have here for you, it allows you a space to write your goals down. I encourage you tomorrow when it's quiet, write your goals down on here. Think about what you really want to do with your life and write your goals down. And then make a plan. So you've written your goals down. What are you going to do now? Make an action plan. The third page of this document here allows you to think about how are you going to achieve your goals. And this is your action plan. And so look at it now, but tomorrow when it's quiet at home, I really want you to take some time to do it. The other steps, study hard. You're going into Form 1 now. Trust me, everything, you know, don't listen to what people say. You know, some people say, you will never do that kind of math algebra again. No, you will do algebra. I did algebra this week at work. So you will do algebra. This is the foundation. What you're learning here now in secondary school is what is going to take you through to be successful in university, for you to get your bachelor's degree and your master's degree and your doctorates. Study hard. Read. I want to tell you all, read everything that you possibly can. Read your textbooks in school. Read novels by great authors. Read literature books. Read business books. Yes, business books. They are business books for kids. Read business books. Read everything you can, because learning never stops, you know. Learning never stops. In fact, when you go back to school on September 8th, I will also be enrolling in a course and I will be starting my class on September 8th. Because although I have my university degree and so on, learning never stops. I have to continue learning. And so you and your lives will be successful if you continue learning. Always, always continue learning. And this will help you keep focus on your goals and your dreams, and this is how you will be successful. And so I know some people might have been a little shy, but I know we have a lot of proud citizens of San Fernando here, young citizens. And I'm telling you, the adult citizens of San Fernando here, we are very, very proud of you, young citizens. And we want to tell you congratulations again. Work hard. You're about to embark upon a journey. In secondary school, you're going to meet the friends that you will have for the rest of your life. You're going to learn the things that you need to be successful. You're going to have fun. Sometimes, you know, you might learn about yourself. And that's the key thing, eh? In secondary school, you're going to grow up and you're going to learn who you are. And so I want to say, enjoy, make the right choices, and congratulations again.
That is it? That is it? Oh, nice. That was Mercedes-Benz. Mercedes. Mercedes-Benz goes, the wrong B I use, the wrong B. All right, Ole. Up next, we have our Honorable Councillor, Ms. Sherry Ali, here to give you all a word of upliftment. Ms. Sherry Ali.
Good evening, all. Proper protocols observed, especially to the Deputy Chair. I'm sorry, the Chairman of San Fernando West and the Deputy Mayor. I'm not going to make you guys stand again, but can I at least see a show of hands of all the students we're honoring tonight? Don't be shy. It's your night. Don't be shy. You have all your new books, your new uniform, everything new, new book bags, new shoes, right? This is a new phase in your life. This is a very new and very big beginning. And let me tell you, one of the first things I always respect about children, especially in the political arena, is, and you're not children anymore, you're young adults, but you still speak your mind. Whatever you're thinking, you say out loud. And you don't care who's listening. You really don't care who you offend. You're just telling it like it is. Snap, right? And I admire that. And I encourage children, young adults, to keep that. One of the things that young adults usually notice about me, especially as a minor public figure, is that I talk funny. I have a funny accent. Yes, I do. I am Trinidadian. You see, you're laughing because she done already saying, "Oh, why, girl, why is she talking like that?" But I, Trinidadian, went to NAPSCLS, productive NAPSCLS, went through the system. Back in my day, showing my age, it was common entrance exam. It was an SEA. So I'm as old as the hills. But you can laugh. You can laugh at my expense. But I was educated abroad, and I traveled the world. And the one thing that I can come back and return to my country and give back to you young folks is that no matter where I ended up, even in Japan, I ran into a Trinidadian. Because what Trinidad produces the best of is education. And Trinidadians take that education, which is par none in the Eastern Caribbean, no competition whatsoever, to the rest of the world. There is a Trinidadian, an educated, strong, fulfilled, accomplished Trinidadian everywhere. And I encourage you children, you young adults, I'm sorry, to become that and to give that and to do that back, even if it's on a level of talent. Not all of us are cut out for school, but what we don't have book-wise, we have talent-wise. We have strengths. God gave us gifts in many degrees, and there is always going to be something that we know we're good at. Take that something that you know you're good at, whether it's musical, artistic, or academics, and give it back to not just your country, Trinidad and Tobago, but to the world as a whole. Because the world is looking at you as you begin your journey, and it is an incredible journey, and this is just a very big step in that direction, and it's a huge accomplishment, and you should very well be recognized for it. And with all that aside, I will keep this very short and wish you all congratulations and a good evening.
Thank you, Ms. Sherry Ali. Before we take a little break, I have one positive man that I want to come and deal with all here. Girl is straight, and he's a big man in the community, right? He was the former MP, the chairman of this. Right now, he's the chairman of the San Fernando West constituency, and he is the deputy mayor of San Fernando West. Coming to represent the mayor's office, I want to present Mr. Junior Ugello to you all.
Dr. Roderick Looney and Pastor as well, Councillor Sherry Ali, Mrs. Deborah Elder, Miss Mercedes Belgrove, Mr. Fahi from FCB, and Ms. Samuel from the Ministry, members of the community, ladies and gentlemen, and our very special guest this evening. After Mercedes' very comprehensive, inspirational speech, and Sherry Ali as well, I want to have a different conversation with you guys in terms of we can. And you'd have heard that from probably Barack Obama. He said, yes, you can. And I really want to talk about what you can do and the possibilities that you have with you, looking at you. Particularly because there's a concept that you are from a sort of depressed community. That's how society may look at you. So you have a major responsibility. How do you treat that? And my story begins with a gentleman, and the story may be a bit lengthy, but very profound, and I would like you to concentrate on what I have to say. So I need your total attention, this group across here. The others can ignore me, but I want you to listen to me. A young engineer left Italy way back in the 1950s and came to Trinidad to work. He was working at Texaco at the time. And because he was young and a bachelor, he had to get somebody to do his housekeeping for him. So let me add, being an Italian, he was a white man, so you'll understand what I'm talking about. So an African or black woman from Vistabella was hired to be his housekeeper. But as things happened, after a while, a relationship began between this black woman and this white man. And as they progressed, she got pregnant. The people of Texaco at the time found out that this white man and this housekeeper who having a relationship, and he was transferred to Palasico. Of course, he carried the woman with him. Again, they found out that she was living with him, and he was transferred to Venezuela, Texaco, Venezuela. And while making arrangements for her to go to Venezuela with him, again, they found out that he was sent back to Italy. The young lady never saw the man again, but she had the child. She couldn't live with this child because somebody the color of this, having a child mixed with straight hair, that's what would be a problem for her during that time. So she dropped that child off to her parents, and that child grew up with her parents, which is the child's grandparents. And then she went on and she had four children for four different men, and ended up living on the line. You know where the line is, you all know where the line is, down by the sea across there. So she lived there for a while, and the child went there a couple of times to spend vacation with her and experience very hard times, because the meal of the day would have been crab and dumpling. The dumpling we made from salt and water and flour, and the crab is which you catch in the backyard, not the crab that you buy. You go out there at night and you set your little wooden trap, and in the morning you go and you catch the crab. But sometimes you push your hand down into the hole and you hold the crab by the back and pull it out, and that was your meat for the day. So they grew up on that. That child went to primary school and felt that school was not interesting. I dropped out of primary school because school was not interesting. Did not go to secondary school, but at age 13 found a panyard and found that the panyard was interesting, interesting place to be. So the child pursued the steel man world. And what was important about that world is that one day that child got measles and didn't go to the panyard for about 2 weeks. But the leader of the band went to his home and said, "We miss you." And that was very profound. That meant something to that child, because finally he was accepted somewhere. And that child stayed with the panyard. That child became committed. And somewhere along the line, that child realized, well, I need to do something for myself. And why am I telling you this story? Because that child today is the deputy mayor of San Fernando. That child is a former member of parliament. That child has a degree. And all of that was done when he grew up. So you never say that it's impossible for you. You can't look at your situation and say, well, I cannot do it. Yes, you can. Your circumstances, your situation, regardless of how difficult it is, you have to hope, live in hope. And I would like that child, or this person speaking to you, to be your example. You go out and do what you have to do. And I think Mercedes, and both Mercedes and Sherry couldn't put it better. Your future is at hand there. You do what you have to do. I'd like my story to be an interesting story, to be profound enough to impress upon you what you're capable of doing. And with these few words, I thank you for giving me the opportunity for sharing my life story with you.
Rigolo, before you go back and sit down, Mr. Rigolo, we have some young ladies want to say something to you. I think, hold on, should I avoid?
On behalf of Carlton Lane Community Group and the Cachora Jewelers, I would like to present this gold brooch to you. Hope you like it.
Yes, yes. Okay, we want to break for the refreshment. DJ, can run a little small affair here, which is the manager of the Citizen Bank, to do his part on awarding the awardees. So, Mr. Affair here, I'd like to take you, I'd like to bring it to the mic.
Hi, good night everyone. I must say it's a pleasure for me to stand before you to honor these young men and women in terms of their achievement at SEA for 2015. For me, it's a personal thing in that I have a son who also did SEA this year, and he was successful also. So parents, earlier on when the MC spoke about the parents and the children standing up and honoring him, I must say, Mr. MC, you took that from me. Okay? I was going to say something like that. So now I have to find something else to say. I promise you it's not homework, but just as Mr. Regrello, I can remember walking through Gob City a year or two ago, and someone walked up to me and said, "Aren't you someone important?" And all right, so thanks for that. Yeah, as the, well, all protocols observe, as the MC said, I'm a representative from First Citizens Bank. On behalf of the management and staff of First Citizens Bank, especially the staff at the Gulf City branch of First Citizens, I want to say congratulations to the SAA students. And I want to say it was, how should I put it? When Mr. Clifton, Hollis Clifton, came to me and said his group, the Carlton Lane Community Group, were going to honor the SEA students, I immediately jumped at it and I said yes. The figure he was talking about giving them was kind of high, so I had to say no to that. But I think what we're presenting to you here, small tokens, and also the opportunity to start what we call a neo savings. It's a savings account that is geared towards young people in terms of, you would have seen it on the papers, all the different little competitions and things. If you go online, as many of you young people would know, the NEO product from First Citizens is one of the leading products in the banking sector. So on behalf of, as I said, the management and staff of First Citizens, I want to present you with these tokens and the opportunity to open a NEO account. Savings, one of the most important things, because what you have to do is you have to take small steps in terms of your savings in order to reach your goal. Anything you want to achieve in life, it's not just one big jump. It's little steps you have to make in order to achieve it. So on behalf of the management and staff of First Citizens, I just want to present you with these small tokens of appreciation.
The presentation of the awardees. So I just bought it. Yeah. Okay, but I will call them out. Okay. Yeah. So we have Destiny Haynes. Destiny Haynes, come. Come forward, please. Next, we have Judah Brown. Judah went to Monrepo RSC and passed to Pleasantville Secondary. And Destiny Haynes, she went to Anstey Memorial Girls and she passed for BB High. So up next, we have Chelsea Stewart. Chelsea.
Chelsea went to Monifo RC and moved on to Gasparillo Composite School. Up next, we have...
Hello, mic one.
We have Chelsea's sister, which is Amoya Stewart, who also went Monifo RC and also moved on to Gasparillo Composite. Next we have, well, this person went to San Fernando Girls Government and moved on to Pleasantville Secondary. We have Alicia Humphrey. We have Alice Martin. Alice also went to San Fernando Girls. No, San Fernando Girls Anglican, sorry. I moved on to San Fernando East Secondary School. Next week, we'll be calling Malachi Pope. Malachi went to San Fernando Boys Government School. And from as of August, he'll be attending the Southern Academy. Next, we'll be having Regina Jemat, San Fernando SDA. Now Miss Jemat goes to Pleasantville Secondary School. We argue too much, we made a mess. What it used to be love, so why don't I care? Next we have Kyle Dulal. Kyle went to Coffee Boys Anglican. Now he attends San Fernando East Secondary School. Having Sophia Alam, and well, unfortunately she was not here, she could not have made it, so we'll have her dad collect hers. Sophia Alam, she went to St. Gabriel's RC, and now she attends the San Fernando Central School, known as MUDSEC. Myself the same thing. I want to call Alexia Brown, which is not here. She had something to do in church today, so unfortunately she could not have been here. She attended the San Fernando Girls Anglican, and now she attends San Fernando West. Again. Okay, that was it for the children that wrote SEA this year. So the rest of names that I'll be calling was backdated because of the years gone by that this ceremony was not in procession. So, oh, Oh, sorry, one more. I have Daniel Grant. Sorry about that. I have Daniel Grant. Daniel attended Coffee Boys Anglican, and he now goes to the San Fernando East Secondary School. Daniel, sorry about that, Daniel. Leave you out, boy.
Nah, man.
And the names that are about to call, as I said, was backdated because of the program was not in session since 2009. Right? So I want to call April Patton.
I gave my best, it wasn't enough. He came and said, we argued too much. We made a mess, but it used to be love.
April went to Anstey Memorial Anglican, and she also attends San Fernando Central, also known as Mudsec. Up next we have Shari Pierre. Shari went to San Fernando Girls Government School, and now Shari attends DB High. I'm a little partner going on call here. He went Coffee Boys, and now he going San Fernando East, Pleasantville. Cali boy, watch my minute now, partner. The next young man I'm about to call, he went to San Fernando SDA, and he moved on to St. Benedict's College. Jai Walker.
From San Fernando Girls Underclass. She passed from Naprima Girls High School. She was the only girl at that year that had passed from Naprima Girls High School. Let's put her arms for Aliyah Brown. But she's not here today. Her father would be collecting the token. Proud father.
Okay, we want Mr. Junior Regalo. Mr. Junior, I want to have something to give the kids. So to the telephone, so he can.
Also, we have the Skiffle have a contribution to make to the students as well. So we'll do that before we make our contribution. I looked at the 17, can I get your attention please, of you all who came up here, and only one person from the 17 plays in this band. Can you stand please? Only one person from the 17 who lived in this area played in this band, and she played for Panama Finals this year. And that is so unfortunate because Skiffle rarely is in your community. This is where this band is. And I think she's the only person, I think your sister as well, or your cousin with us, right? Playing in the band. Most of the members from this band coming from as far as Otaheite, Pleasantville, Cousin Madeline, Marabella, and the people around here do not utilize this band. The young man who played the national anthem, he went to Grand Memorial Presbyterian School and started playing here at age 6, playing for Panama at age 6. Can you just stay down with the numbers? It's an example of some of the problems we have in society. I'm telling you about the young man who played the national anthem. Because of this ban, he went to New York a couple times, Cuba, Jamaica, Barbados, because he played the national instrument. He just came back from the Czech Republic, Austria, and Germany about 2 weeks ago. So there are opportunities for you if you play the national instrument. He's also an upper six student at Naparima Boys, and he spent the past, I would say, 12 years in the Spaniard. He came here at about 3 months old, because his mother works abroad sometimes. She's a traveling officer. And I will take a box from across the road, put a pillow in the box, and he will sleep in the box while the band practicing. It did not interfere with his development or his progress, and right now he's doing pretty well with his academics. So I'm saying that there's hope again for you all, and I wish that the whole of Carlton Lane and Roy Joseph and Upper Hillside and Lower Hillside can take control of this band, because I could tell another side to this band, this property is valued $8 million about 2 years ago, so it should be more by now. And I don't own it, the band own it. So you should see yourself as a future owner of this band, and being part of this and the goodies that comes with it. So I would like to see some of you all enlist, enroll, get involved in this band and be part of this careful family and the future. So on behalf of the band, I want to do a little contribution here, but in any particular order. First come, you seem to be not focused. Come. All right. Where are your parents? Anybody here? Yeah. Yeah, work with him. I'll be looking at him all evening, right? And send him by me. I'll take care of him. If you have any problems, send him. Let me take him for the next 5 years. You'll be proud of him. All right, let's start. Okay, thanks. This is just a help. It's a small gesture from the man. Sorry. At least he's proud to be Trinidadian, right? Well done, son. What's your name? Judah, it's a big name, you know. Are you aware of that? You ever read about Judah in the Bible? You don't know? Mercy they say you have to read. Next. Anyone? Congratulations. Congratulations. Well, Glenn, who's next? Right, the process has to be, you all have to be fast then, you have to be quick. By the time I hand this one, next one should be up here already. This is the problem we have in this country, you all are slow. Right, who's next? Congratulations. Yeah. I know he's taking pictures, but it's important. Hello. I ain't cutting it. Red, white, and black is important. Congratulations, young lady. What school are you going to? Pleasant Valley Second. Do well. Make us proud. More? Congratulations. What school are you going to? Pleasant Valley. I want to see you in the Panyard, okay? I want to see you in the Panyard too. What's your name? Malakai. Malakai. That's a big name too, you know. You aware of that name? History of that name? Google it. Who's next? Congratulations. You look like a pan player. You should come to the yard too. Congratulations. You should be around the pan for the whole season, but in touch one pan. Live in the pan for the whole panorama season. Okay? That's it? Yes. Congratulations. Yeah. Keep your shoulders up. That's it. And I also want to have something for the basketball players in Carlton Lane. So I want to call Jim forward. Right? That's a ball. Right? And I have an MVP award. Is he here? Yeah. Somebody give me a size 16 boots. And I say, I must find somebody a size 16. And I said, there's a young man in Carlton Lane with a size 16. So you take this to the size 16 young man. Tell him this on behalf, for me to him, okay? Thank you very much.
Yeah. Okay, thanks, Mr. Junior Igalo.
Oh, my program. Sorry about that.
So we'll go full speed ahead with our the program. I want to introduce a nice, warm-speaking lady from the Ministry of Gender, Youth and Child Development. All I want to let her take in what she has to say. And she will be doing our vote of thanks, which is the last item on our program tonight. So, Ms. Wendy Samuel, would you please accompany me on the floor?
Good night, everybody. So you all know my name is Wendy Samuel, yes? My name is Wendy Samuel. Good. I am so proud. Well, I represent the Ministry of Gender, Youth and Child Development. I'm a youth officer with the ministry. And I am so proud for all of you who passed your, we say it in my time, common entrance, for all of those who passed the SCA. I must tell you something tonight, I didn't pass mine. I didn't pass any common entrance. You know something? I looked at the list of names to some of the students that passed for the junior secondary school. I went to junior sec, and I went to senior sec. And I can tell you today, I have a bachelor's and a master's degree. That didn't keep me back. The junior sec didn't keep me back. Oh, there's another thing. I always looked for, like, this little sister here, and I saw another one. I think she's a Boyd. I always look for chubby girls. Because I have been a chubby girl. Always a chubby girl. But you know something? I played basketball. I sang. I did rugby. You can keep me back because my nature was to be chubby. And it's something my mother told me years ago that stayed with me. She said, you're already big, you're dark, you have to be seen in a positive light. So when they say Wendy Samuel, hey, I feel so good, it's me. I am Wendy Samuel. Mr. Clifton, you know that, he taught me in school. I am Wendy Samuel, I'm proud, so be proud of your name. Be proud of who you are. And most of you, you see how some of you have your parents here? I used to be a foster care officer. And we call some of those children fondlings. Anybody can tell me the meaning of a fondling? Hey, the meaning of a fondling. A fondling is a child that is found. Don't know their parents. I have children that we found in the bus terminus in Sanwo, and you name it. Don't know who they are. But you know, under my purview, they know who they are. So on their birth certificates, their name is Wendy Simon. And like I told one last week, you ain't gonna let me down. You coming first in tests at all times. Because your mother is Wendy Samuel. Be proud of your name, the Jaheem, the, you know, we like to say, is a Tanya, is a Laya. You know the, you know the names now go with a Lala, a Dada. You know the names go with that now, right? It's a so-so. You know the names have a way, and they have a way of calling, like, you know, sometimes I'm in the office on coffee here, and sometimes I come outside and stand up. I feel so proud to be on the coffee, and I hear some people that come from food basket or wherever they come from with their bags. And Tanya, wait, Nadial. That's not how you pronounce your name. What's your name? I saw you laughing when somebody came up here for the award for junior sec. Hello, let me see those who passed for the junior sec. Listen, sometimes I'm right on the coffee there. Feel free to come. Just ask Sir Wendy Samuel. You don't have to say miss or anything. Just ask Sir Wendy Samuel. And I'll leave my number with Dwayne so you can contact me. Let nobody laugh at nobody now. I went to junior sec. I went to senior sec. Proud of my school. The same university I went, some of the girls from Naps and Convent went to the same university too. Hello. Some of them, my boyfriend, they wanted my boyfriend. But you know something? The boys chose me.
I'm saying this to you to tell you, you don't have to wear your clothes short. You don't have to sit with your legs open. You don't have to bow your ass 5 times. You don't have to tattoo your beautiful butt. You don't have to scar up your body. You can be beautiful in your own skin. Yes? You can be beautiful in your own skin. You know, I'm walking up the steps and, you know, getting a little older. So, you know, I'm taking my time. My husband kind of agile, look him there. So he coming up, come on, that girl. Taking my time. Walking up the step. And I saw some girl and, you know, the language. Hey, you are little queens. So what's your language? What's your language? What's your name?
Amoya.
Amoya. Hear that name? You hear what you say it? Say it with more spunk.
Amoya.
Amoya. What's your name? Amoya. What's your name? Amoya. What's your name? Amoya. What is the last one? What the last one says to you? Did you not hear me? My name is Amoya. It's not funny. I want you to go out there. I'm just finished a program in my catchment area, which is Faizabad, or put all those areas. And we call it the AIP. See what y'all are doing here, the award ceremony? We call it the Adolescent Intervention Program. The ministry calls it that program. And let me just give you a little example before I sit down, because I like to talk. Let me give you a little example of what has happened to a young boy from that program. This young boy, very insignificant, sits very quickly in the class. So, you know, because I was juvenile officer before, I said, probably this little boy have a little problem. Not saying anything, getting a feedback from the mic. Okay, I'll put it so. Okay, so this little boy wasn't saying much in the class. So lunchtime, I will look at him again. He's not bringing any lunch, and he's not taking any box lunch either. Asked the teacher, what is happening to him? You know what she said? He's poor, but he's bright. He is what? He's poor, but he's bright. So, you know, regardless that he's poor and bright, she labeled him already. You all will be labeled, eh? Sometimes they will label you. But you know something? You would make people label you if you want to make people label you. Because I ain't know nothing about no labeling, you know. Because nobody ever called me fat. They can't do it. They're not brave enough. Nobody never called me fat. Look at she. Yeah, see, she never got that. You know what I got? Who is she? I'm going back to the little boy. So when I got into the little boy now, you know what's happening to that little boy? That little boy, yes, very poor family, but very bright. Today, somebody tell me what school that boy passed for. Anybody? No? That boy passed for Presentation College. And you know what that little boy told me? He said, well, they call me auntie, whatever. He said, auntie, you know why I'm not eating the box lunch? It has too much chemicals. He laughed at that. The box lunch has too much chemicals. Do you see how the cucumber runs? So I'm saying to you, it's not where you came from. I remember years ago, I couldn't line with nobody from Carlton Lane. My father will put me out. You can't line with nobody from Carlton Lane. You can't line with nobody from certain places because you can't go there. But you can make the difference. Each of you can make the difference. And again, I'm saying to you, it's not where you came from, but it's where you're going. And you all have the opportunity to excel. It's not what school they come from, like the little one here laugh when they say San Fernando East. What is wrong with San Fernando East? The same teachers there went to the same university with teachers from Prez and Naps and all these other schools. Make a difference in your life. Boys will come and boys will go. Vagina is always there. Penis is always there. Ain't going nowhere. That ain't going nowhere. You understand? And you know some of you like to rush it? Don't rush it.
Don't rush it. It ain't going nowhere. It ain't getting smaller. It ain't getting bigger. It's same thing. You understand? So stop rushing life. Enjoy life. Embrace life. You understand what I'm saying? Embrace life. Nice young Nubian sisters. Embrace life. Yes? And Dwayne will have my number. Feel free. When I'm in the office, come. You don't even have to call. Just come ask Sir Wendy Samuel. You don't have to say miss. You don't have to say nothing. Just ask Sir Wendy and I'll entertain you. Just like Dwayne came in the office, Dwayne, and we became friends immediately. Like we know each other for years. You know, because I saw something in this young man. And he had to see something in you to be carrying on this. So, what I could tell you the ministry can do for you is that we can assist you in certain programs, like in your sexuality, because I know some of you itchy from the minute the boy kiss the air, they feel, oh God, he love me. You know? Or he hold your hand, or he send you a WhatsApp. Or you're on Facebook. Don't let me catch all you on Facebook with all you're bending over and them kind of thing, eh? You know, you can't go on Facebook at a certain age, right? Yeah? You're very pretty. So, enjoy your school life. You too. Sorry, I didn't find she looked like me when I was her age. Yes. That's my husband right there. You see him? I saw him and I had to have him. And that is what it's all about, you know, when you reach a certain age and whatever you want, you can get. You know, whatever you want, you can get it, right?
Yeah.
Of course. Whatever you want, it's there for you to grab. That's how the universe is made up of. Whatever you want, you can get it. You went home and changed your clothes. You went home and changed your clothes. Yes, I like when he said that. I have to freshen up. I sat there and I listened to some of you. And I see some of you kind of skylarking on the rail and thing. You know? I'm saying that's not what it's about. Sit in the chair. The chair was provided for you. And sit properly. Sit properly. Let me see you sit properly. Sit up. The other little brother who's trying to sit in one chair. There's other chairs. Go and sit there. The one in the all sport red jersey sit on another chair. And the one who has itself twisted, the back is for your back. So sit properly. Sit up. And in life, sit up. Look up. And you'll reach where you're going. Thank you.
Samuel, thank you, thank you. Words of encouragement, and I hope all of you take it in. That was powerful words from Samuel. Trust me when I tell you that. I think Mr. Hollis have something that he'd like to do. Mr. Hollis? Yeah.
Thank you, and thank you, Jim. Now, this one is a surprise, right? This is a little award we want to give to a young lady in the community of Carlton Lane. She's very active. If you say Zumba, she's in the basketball court. If you say five-a-side, she is the one who has the mic and announcing every team that's going to play on the court, who they're going to play, who they beat. You know the kind of girl that is? If I show you that young lady, you will just bawl. Shania! On behalf of the Carlton Lane Community Group, you're crying? We would like to present you this, but don't get tempted, right? Give it to Shanna and Daphne. You're here because if you look at this, you see what is tempting about it? You notice it's all kind of chocolate and all kind of sweet, ting, Nestle stuff, right? So it's for the whole family, right? Yeah. Don't go in a corner and play licking it up. You want to have the top, right? Yes, hold it, let me shoot you.
Thank you. I know I appreciate it.
Okay. Well, that this year was the second to last item on the program tonight. I want to seal it up with entertainment, a little entertainment for the awardees and their parents. Tonight, we have Impulse here for you all. So, Impulse, can do your thing? Well, I love it.
Well, that I want to say a very wonderful good night, each and everyone. Say, yeah, yeah. Correct us right now. I realize what the function is all about, and I hear some nice words from the coming from Miss Samuel. Or give Miss Samuel a nice round of applause. But what I know, what I realize, you know, we don't teach of our culture. We teach a fraction. But if I ask Oli, what is a calypso, what Oli will tell me? Oli don't know, ain't it? A calypso is rhythm and rhyme with a constructive storyline, something said but not said, and is the only beat is a heartbeat. Remember that. Because when I come from England, Sunday gone, I went on tour, and when you're out there and they ask what is a calypso, you have to answer them. Correct? So they need to teach those things. So let me show you. Calypso is just poetry that we sing. Let me give all you a little idea of it. The name of this song is Matrimony. Let me go. Now, crazy computer. Hey,
hey. Volume, real music.
I'd rather be the sweet man, no wedding again. I'd rather be the sweet man, I ain't prepared for so much pain.
No, hey.
Mr. B sent a big computer for me, programmed to give married men advice, how to treat women nice. But the first button that I press, I hear a whole lot of foolishness. If you want your woman to love you, allow she to have a sweet man or two. This computer crazy. Good Lord, this computer mad. This computer wants me to get to prison for somebody.
Hey, reading.
Oh, you find a computer crazy? So I'm going to press a next button. I ain't like that button. So I'm going to press a next button. When I press the button, hear what I hear.
Hey!
Don't come home unexpectedly. You might see what you shouldn't see. When you're close to home, you must blow your horn in case something going on. And if you don't have a horn to blow, make a loud noise that she could know. Give the sweet man a chance to escape fast if you want your marriage to last. This computer crazy. Good Lord, this computer mad. This computer want me to end up in the hangman cemetery.
Hey,
hello, DJ.
Thank you. That the name of that song was Crazy Computer. You find that computer crazy? Telling me some odd thing. Yeah? All I wanted, bro. Now, you know, we had a political competition coming up, which was the 28th, but I had canceled. I don't know why I did it, because I cut my tour in half to be here, because my tour was supposed to end on the 6th of September. But I cut it because it says it's on the 28th. So I reached here on the 23rd to get audition, rehearsal and stuff, and I had to cancel it. But this was one of the songs I was about to sing. The name of it is Matrimony.
Kublush, 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 kush, kush, kush.
Hey, give me now. Reading, volume, hear this.
I dream a wedding in the Philippines. A big shot wedding, the best I ever seen. Old fashioned wedding, old fashioned thing. Old fashioned dress code, old fashioned bling. Dancing and jumping and whining whole night. The wedding went non-stop until morning light. Camera marijuana, they what a dream. Camera marijuana in the Philippines. Camera marijuana on the compound. Camera marijuana, it was a massive one. Wanna was happy, all in the glee. Wanna say he want a dog lap baby. So Camera marijuana, they what a dream. Camera marijuana in the Philippines. Camera marijuana body compound. Come la marijuana. It was a massive one. It's a wedding, eh? So it's come la marijuana, right? Nice, let me know. Read it. Hey, yellow. Hear this. Music. Come, still doing the jig. Come like Inchi can come and looking big. Come like getting tired, so she start to brace. Wanna like he gone mad, only trading waste. Drinking and smoking, and who want to fly? Wanna get drunk and come like get high. Come like marijuana, like what a dream. Come like marijuana, in the Philippines, hey. Come like marijuana, on the compound. Come like marijuana, it was a massive one. And in the wedding, with two red woman, who pull from he, two pull from she, two pull and then he gone. Hey, come la marijuana, that what a dream. Come la marijuana, in the Philippines. Hey, come la marijuana, on the compound. Come la marijuana, it was a massive one. Hey, freezing. Now, they're going on divorce here. Find the old man, tell me they're going on divorce. Get it? Hey, freezing. And they say, put back on that. With the fellas, don't like the wedding at all. Wanna get the money, that I understand. They take the money and they still don't like the man. So they're ranting and raving and bumping their gum. But while they're chanting, the wedding going on. Come la marijuana, that what a dream. Come la marijuana, in the Philippines. Hey, come la marijuana, give me now. Come la marijuana, hey. Pasta coffee talking and don't have a clue. I feel the pasta want to marijuana to sing. Come on, hey. Thank you. Yeah, how's it, Paul?
All right. Well, in closing, again, I want to thank all the little children, all the future stars of our nation, and once we have a bright mind, we sure as elders we see a bright future. So I'll give all yourself a round of applause, and I wish you all the best in life, better than mine's. So, Ole, it's an old Jamaican saying. An old Jamaican saying goes, Rockstone will live at the river ground, nah no sun hot. That simply means who feels it knows it. Right? So you all keep that in mind and wish you all the best again. I'm working with you all right. No, much more.
Thank you.